Pain of Bucks is Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my grown, extended, beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support that you're giving yourselves, as well as, you know, other people as well. You know, all of us having positive energy to, you know, pass it on through other people is truly a blessing. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. If you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about you giving positive feedback to the content of my video, that's what I meant to say. Or you just tell me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. And if you feel like the video is very informative to you, or just gives you good vibes, you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, or even a fellow empath that are going through some really trying times and need spiritual guidance or any confirmation or validation towards their life path or even soul purpose, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. Thank you once again for the love and support, is so greatly appreciated, and I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. It's been a long time since I actually did like 9 or 10 videos, so it's just a blessing that, you know, God's actually given me this energy to do this. I don't know if it has something to do with me eating a lot of fruit for the last few days or what, but I'm like, lately I'll be tired after like 5 or 6 videos, but now I'm just like, woo, okay, let me go ahead and share. The video I'm listening to in the background, the meditation music I'm listening to in the background, is called Sound Bath, Divine Cosmic Energy. Cleanse all unwanted feelings, emotion, and negative feelings. And that is like very beautiful. You know, we all need that in our lives. And I know it is just like messing with my third eye. Ooh, Jesus. but anyways, the video that I'm doing right now is called Twin Flame 101. Heyoka, certain situations come along your paths to test you. Know that your choice can either hinder you or elevate you. You have to be very careful, because it's just like, it could be, you know, it's just like I told you about pot tests we can have, you know, in school. Like, you know, you had to be able to, teacher will tell you at the beginning of the week, hey, I'm going to give you a pop quiz. I ain't going to tell you exactly what day it's on, because that's all how pop quiz at, you know, came along. And see that flashing light just messed me up. The flashing light messed me up. But going through all the pop quiz and stuff like that, you know, you have to be able to study on research and do whatever it is on whatever subject it is. And that's just like, you know, the process of life. You know, God and universe, as well as darkness, will place us in certain situations to see how we'll react. You know, especially when it comes to negative situations. You know, are you gonna be that person that, you know, allows whatever negative situation come about to, you know, put you in a bad mood, stop you from doing whatever your process is that's on the positive? You know, there are certain things that used to get on my nerves to where it'll stop my flow on my positivity. And I said, you know, now I'm like, you know what, I'm not even about to let you affect me in the way it was. You know, just like the situation that just passed, you know, I'm up here doing my video and then my ex want to come in here and start doing stuff, and I'm just like, okay, you ain't about to stop my flow. You know, I'm gonna keep going. And I said, even though you were trying to make me laugh or whatever, I'm not gonna be dealing with you right now. I'm gonna go ahead and continue finishing my video out and do what I need to do. You know, it's like stuff like that, or people you deal with throws you one of them negative bones to try to work your last daggone nerve. Sometimes I used to tell people, when things come your way like that, sometimes a reply is no reply at all. Sometimes you got to reply to fools like that, you know, because if you know that if they know whatever they can do can affect you, that lets them know, oh, I still got their power in my hand. I can still affect them like that. Because sometimes you just got to ignore folks. You can't be, you know, throwing a bone back and forth like that. You know, you have better things to put your focus on, because there's a lot of things like that can mess you up, mess your blessings up. Like, God, I already knew God was sitting up here testing me with certain people that came in my life, you know, just to rekindle something, knowing they done caused some really bad damage to my life. You know, and there's, you know, one or two of them I could just cuss right out. Then after that, God, for a while, you know, it was teaching me, you can't, just because people enter your life and they did not make that positive impact on you, like y'all really ended on a bad note, sometimes you ain't even gotta respond. Oh, hey, thanks for stopping by, thanks for, you know, trying to, you know, say hey to me, but I'm going about my business. Or, you know, those people that came past my page, you know, on Goodwill, you done tried to throw some bad juju on me, and I'm just like, I didn't even reply, I just blocked your behind, and I ain't even got nothing to say to you. You know, what it is what it is, but you can get up out of my life. You know, there's a lot of people that do that, you know, because it's just like sad that people's lives are miserable, you know, so they try to affect yours as well. I can say something like, oh, you know, I'm just, you know, just trying to clear my life with anything that is, you know, not serving me. And some people like, ooh, you know, what's up, you know? And I'm just like, God, dog, is your life that bad that you got to sit here about my problems? I'm like, oh, I'm good. And that's why I said, if it was irrelevant or wasn't important to me, it ain't worth me talking to you about. You know, so it's just like, you have to be able to roll with the punches and be able to know when you're constantly being tested. Or, you know, there could be somebody that, you know, you'll sit up here, like if you're on Facebook or something like that, and you know how some of them posts will come up, would you give your last dollar to a person in need? And you're like, oh yeah. Then God gonna place that person in your life and ask you, hey, do you mind if it could be your last couple of quarters and stuff like that? I've done that, you know, and I'm like, well, I wish I had more for you, but this is all I had, you know. And then it's like God blessing you then, but it was like I did that because, you know, I can feel like they really were in need of it. Now, it's just like, I don't see people, because down here in Georgia, you're able to buy cigarettes, like one per, you know, you can buy them in singles and stuff like that. Like, oh, do you have a cup? No, I'm not about to support your habit. I even stopped supporting my own habit. I ain't about to support yours. Now, if it's something to get something to eat or drink like that, like when it's water or a soda or something, not no liquor or not no cigarette, you know, I'm not about to do that when it's one of those things that you really don't need to have anyway, because if it was meant for you to have, God would have made sure you had some money for that. But if it's about to feed your hunger or something like that, I'd be glad to do that, but I'm buying you some food. I ain't about to give you that money. Just because I already know it might be going somewhere else, but you're going to make sure you got something to eat. But, you know, the things are just like that in your life, where you know you can do something from the kindness of your heart, being selfless. You know, there's people that, you know, I do one-on-one with, and they were like, Roslynn, how can I repay you? You just being happy and understanding that you ain't crazy, you ain't the only one going through that, that's the way you can pay me back, is just to let me know that you got peace and love in your heart and understanding this is a certain situation you had to go through because, you know, all these different things, and I was able to make sense of this. Those are my blessings. And, you know, I was like, don't be trying to buy me nothing or whatever. That's like blocking my blessings. Don't do that, because I'm doing it because I want to do it. You know, I knew what it felt like when I first started this journey. I just had my dad metaphysically. My mom and all my other spirit guides were, you know, guiding me towards certain things. Or I'll hear certain, you know, words in my head and I'll just write it down. I did a lot of spirit writing. Things that I never knew I was able to do. But, you know, after my spiritual awakening, there was a lot of things I never thought I would be able to do that I was able to do. You know, it's just like I knew when I was growing up, there's certain things that I would know about people that there's no way I should have known. But, you know, I was told by my mom's ex-husband, that's like a mental illness. You don't need to be doing that. You can really hurt somebody doing that. And I'm just like, why is it going to hurt somebody if I'm telling them the truth? This is something they needed to know. You know, they're talking to a dead loved one, and I can basically tell them, hey, whatever this, and this is, you told them to, they heard you. And there's a lot of times I've done that to help people. Sometimes it'll scare them away from me. They don't want to talk to me no more. I'm like, that's fine, but at least you're letting you know your friend or your loved one hears you. You know, it can kind of, you know, take people aback, and they be like, well, that's, you know, I was like, well, you got to be careful about what you ask for, you know, because you're going to end up getting it. So it's just like all these different things that has been placed in my life, I'm very grateful for, whether it's a bad experience, whether it's a good experience. Because the bad experience is being able to see them for what they truly are. You know, you can be able to say, hey, the universe put a spotlight on this certain situation you need to handle, but handle it in a, you know, a positive way, not in a negative one. Because it's just like, you know, people that know me for years, and they would see me doing videos like, girl, what did you go through? Because I was always quick to just go popping off of the mouth. If I didn't like you, I would let you know I don't like you, and I wouldn't care how you took it. You know, my mom was like, oh, you're so mean. I said, I ain't trying to be, but I'm just being honest. And my mom's like, sometimes you, it's like, Rosalie, you have no cooth. You have no cooth. You just say, tell people you won't really like them. And I was just, you know, and I was like that. Now I try to be a lot more mindful, you know, because you never know, your words can really hurt somebody's feelings, or, you know, that could be something that might come back on you. So you have to be very careful about, you know, the words you put out, the intentions you put out. Like I've told people, you know, they get mad because certain situations come on, and like, you know, it has happened to them, and they get, oh, I'm gonna get that back. I said, see, you can't do that. You know, even though you might be mad and you feel some type of way, trust me, I know. But if you go back and retaliate against these people, that makes you no better than them. Like I tell you, how people treat you is your karma. How you respond to it is yours. So you allow people to act the fool if they want to act the fool. I deal with it a lot when people come towards me. Some people are okay, but there's some of them that, you know, up in their feelings. I say, I'm going to allow you to do that. I'm going to let you go ahead and do that, because sometimes me walking away is the best. I'm like, Lord, just give me the strength so I don't box this person. Okay, I'm going to just walk off because, you know, no, I'm not about to do that with you, you know, and I'm that person. But it allowed me to be able to heal myself, not being able to let certain situations get to me, because you are being tested. A lot of things are going to come towards your path that's going to piss you off. It's going to rub you the wrong way. But a lot of times you have to see the meaning behind that, because there's a lot of times people are not going to agree with you. There's a lot of people that don't agree with me, and they come at me stupid sometimes. And I'm just like, you know what? I'm going to just let you have that bone and carry it to wherever you thought you were going to carry it to, back to where you know, wherever it came from. I'm not going to allow myself to, you know, stoop to your level, you know, especially, you know, it's better on my channel. There's a lot of things that I speak about. Some people I rub the wrong way. Some people are actually grateful for the things I said, but it's like everything got to be a balance, you know. But it's just the point. I'm blessed that the fact is I don't have to reply to everything that's negative that's said to me, you know, because it's just like, and you have to really say, okay, is this going to contribute to my growth? No. Okay, then. All right. Next question. You know, you have to be able to do that, because you know you're heading towards something beautiful. And when people know that you're heading towards something nice and very beautiful, it's just like they're too busy worried about your journey instead of theirs. A lot of people need to understand, everybody got their own journey. You cannot try to question somebody else's journey, because that was meant for them. Just like I can't question your journey, because that was meant for you. But it's just, you know, people have their bad habit of putting their hands in somebody else's cookie jar, and they need to stop doing that. So allow yourself to know when you are being tested, because a lot of times when things come off the way they come off, and you're like, oh, I'm not gonna allow this day to get me stressed out at all, then somebody comes up and boom, says something to you, aren't you going to still have that good day you said you were? Because, you know, universe just put that in there just to make sure, see if, you know, you really on your stuff. And there are some times I've been set up here and being set up, I say, oh, you won't get me like that. Mm-mm. Nope. You ain't going to get me. I seen it coming, because I'll just be looking. And just got to keep it going. Just keep it going, because you know when you're being tested. But I hope you were able to resonate with the content of this video. Y'all, I'm so blessed that I was able to put out so much information today, because I haven't did like 9 or 10 videos like this in a long time. So I really feel grateful that I'm able to do this. So much love to Sydney. You know who I'm talking to. Much love to you. I'm so glad that, you know, everything is, you know, okay with you or whatever, and I'm good to hear you. You know, I don't want to say your voice, because I ain't hear your voice, but I'm glad you stopped by and dropped me a line or whatever. And I love y'all, and drop me a line. Let me know if, you know, you resonate. It's truly a blessing, you know. And if y'all are interested in my group page on Facebook, Heyoka Spiritual Journey, go ahead and look it up. And, you know, we're just, like I said, I put newsletters out, whatever, like with the lunar eclipse, I put a link out for that. You know, I put funny videos on there, or I put positive posts on there, you know, all of us to be able to, you know, get you out your comfort zone, being able to put stuff. So like, if you have certain songs that help you throughout the day, or even a meditation, I'm gonna start putting meditations on there as well, because I usually send it to people in their messenger, you know, especially the ones that I use, you know, on my videos in the background. And it can really, you know, they really feel like make my energy shift into a positive zen mode. So I love to share that with others, you know, because you never know what people are going throughout the day. You know, if you need somebody to pray for you, allow someone, you don't got to tell your business or whatever what's going on, you just want people to give you a prayer out, or you, if you're experiencing something, you're like, hey, you know, I'm just wondering if blase, anybody else has been experienced this around a certain time. And, you know, I put those out there too, you know, because it's like I'm trying to get people out their comfort zone for them to be able to participate a lot more. Because, like I said, I don't want to close my group down because I've done that before. You know, I'm just trying to be able to not give up on it so soon. Go ahead and just try to, you know, push it out there where other people can, you know, talk about what they feel. And I tell people, it's nobody's gonna make fun of you, because the first time I see somebody say something crazy, they're supposed to say they're out the group, period. I told them that I'm not gonna play that. So you know, like, look that up, you know, see if you would love to be a part of that. You know, like I said, I'm just trying to get people to, you know, come out a little bit more and be able to discuss, you know. I really love doing that. I want to continue to be able to do that as well. But anyways, I hope you have a blessed, grateful day. You know, much love to you, and I will see you on my next video. I'm hoping to put some more videos out tomorrow. So, you know, if this doesn't come out tomorrow, because I don't know, no telling with YouTube, it takes about 4 or 5 days just stuff to come out nowadays. But anyways, much love to you. Like and subscribe, hit that notification bell, share, give me a thumbs up, and send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. You never know, your kind words can really take somebody a long way. And know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, forever loved, and knowing there's always someone out there praying for your better days. Much love. Peace.